cows, pigs, chickens, deer, rabbits. These are all animals that humans around the world regularly eat. But for the most part, the animals we eat don't eat animals. At least not only animals. Humans basically only dine on herbivores and omnivores. Why do we steer clear of carnivores? Hi, I'm Kate, and this is Minute Earth. I am a lover of carnivores and food. So when I sank my teeth into this question, I thought I already had a pretty good idea of what the answer was going to be. But there are actually several really interesting possibilities out there about why we generally keep carnivores off the menu. The first reason we might avoid eating carnivores, and this was my go-to hypothesis before this video, is the safety, or really the unsafety, of their meat. As animals live their lives, they pick up potential nasties, things like parasites, microbes, and heavy metals, some of which can hang around in their bodies and cause harm. When one animal eats another, it adds that animal's nasties to its own nasties. When that animal eater eats another animal, it'll ingest all that animal's nasties. And if something should eat the eater, it'll nom up all those animals' nasties. The idea is that eating animals that eat lots of other animals might expose us to more nasties, and that's not great. We do know that certain animal-eating species do contain high enough levels of certain nasties that make them potentially dangerous for certain humans to consume. But we don't have evidence that this problem applies to humans eating carnivores in general. So let's move on to the second hypothesis, deliciousness. Maybe animals that only eat other animals just don't taste all that good. And because we're dealing with deliciousness, I'm gonna hop over into minute food land for this one. Now, there are a few reasons why carnivore meat might not be particularly tasty. The first is texture. Carnivores tend to be lean, mean hunting machines. They have to be in order to catch their prey. The leaner and stronger an animal is, the less juicy fat it contains, and the thicker its bundles of muscle fibers are. So the tougher its meat is likely to be. And in general, humans aren't big fans of tough meat. Then there's flavor. Because what an animal eats can affect how it tastes. That's why some people care whether they're eating grass-fed or grain-fed beef. Maybe something about eating lots of other animals, like the urea critters tend to contain, or the icky compounds produced when meat sits around, makes a carnivore's meat taste gross. And there is some anecdotal evidence for this. People who've eaten bear during different seasons of the year tend to say that spring bears, which have been gorging on berries, are way tastier than fall bears, which have been feasting on fish. Speaking of fish, though, there is a big exception to this whole humans don't eat carnivores thing. Several of the fish species we eat only eat other animals, and they don't taste bad. Quite the opposite, really. So I'd go so far as to say that the taste hypothesis doesn't hold up, at least not broadly across all carnivores. Let's go back to Minute Earth land to chat about the third hypothesis, inefficiency. At least in modern times, producing enough meat to feed big groups of big hungry humans has generally required raising animals for their meat. And doing this with carnivores just doesn't make that much sense. There's the matter of them seeing us as food, but the bigger problem is that raising carnivores is kind of a waste. If you feed, say, a cow 10,000 calories of grass, most of that energy goes into keeping the cow alive. Only about 10% of it goes into building body mass. So from all this grass, you'll only end up with something like 1,000 calories of beef. That's basically just a couple steaks. And if you feed those 1,000 calories of beef to, say, a tiger, you'll only get 100 calories of tiger meat. It is way more efficient, and easier, to just eat the beef yourself. It's even more efficient to eat the plants yourself, but that is a whole other video. This hypothesis, inefficiency, is the only one that's actually supported by the weird fact that we do eat carnivorous fish. The very same energy loss happens in the ocean, too. But since we've spent most of history just opportunistically catching fish, rather than raising them ourselves, inefficiency here hasn't really mattered to us. But there's still one more hypothesis for why humans don't generally eat carnivores: religion. Judaism does not allow the eating of predators, and the Quran bars eating animals with fangs or talons, which discounts lots of animals that eat only animals. It's not unusual for behaviors to start out as religious practices, then spread outwards and become relatively commonplace. Humans' avoidance of carnivores as a food source may have followed a similar trajectory. Although note that it's possible, likely really, that religious rules about eating carnivores are rooted in other reasons to avoid eating these animals. For example, unsafety, or at least people's perceptions of unsafety, could lead to these kinds of restrictions. Deliciousness, too, could be related to the other hypotheses. Like, if carnivore meat was risky to consume, it's likely that we'd evolve a distaste for it, just like we've evolved to dislike bitter foods, many of which contain potentially dangerous compounds. In other words, this carnivorous culinary conundrum is complicated. And since nobody out there is actually studying it, we don't have a solid answer for why we gobble up cows and chickens, but steer clear of tigers and eagles. But this question is good food for thought, and I, for one, have enjoyed chewing on the possibilities. Since we got on our carnivore kick, we have been having a blast playing Beast Lord: The New Land, which sponsored this video. It's a basic strategy game where you need to explore, find resources, and build alliances, but with a cool ecological twist, which you know we love. You can choose from more than 500 animal characters to unlock and play as, each of which uses characteristic natural behaviors to help the team. And let me just say, the art is amazing. We are big fans of the lion character, which you can get once you log in for 2 days in a row. In this game, lions act like squad captains, so when you put one in your team, it amps up the rest of the squad's expedition skills. When the lion's leading the pack, its attack powers get boosted too. And as your lion gains experience, it increases the rest of the team's attack and defense skills simultaneously, making the whole beast squad even more effective. So join more than 10 million other folks who have downloaded the game, and start playing today. Get started at the links in the description. If you use the code MinuteEarth, they'll hook you up with a bunch of extra resources right at the start. Thanks, Beast Lord.